Okay, everybody, how are you doing? This is Freshly Sniped for Fresh Droid TV, and today we are advertising Core Droid version 1.4. Now, I did 1.3 last time. 1.4 does offer some improvements over the other one. So basically what we have right now are the cameras are skinned more. They were missing building parts, and what they did last time, if you remember, I told you guys about the fixed the T-Mobile patch for the T-Mobile USA users. They're able to differentiate now between the two different devices, and it actually puts the 4G patch up there automatically if you're on the Sensation 4G. They added the Daemon controller, they updated the super user, they updated YouTube, updated Titanium backup, fixed some small glitches and issues, and it loads a lot more faster. So let's take a look. As you can see, remember before, it is beautiful. So instead of the normal ring, it's more like a magnifying glass now. So we're going to go a little more in depth this time. As you can see, I'm a T-Mobile USA user, so there we go. So we're going to enter the password, of course, you know, got to have that. And wow, there we go. So as you can see, it's normal look. I'm about 19% battery, so we're not going to take too long. Let's see. So for you guys that don't believe it's 1.4, let's go ahead and go to About Phone. We're going to go Software Information. And as you can see, it is Core Droid Sensation version 1.4. Now, the kernel version, they have gone back to Legeroid kernel. For reasons unbeknownst to me, I believe that it's a lot more stable, and it looks like Unity's developer has had, he's kind of abandoned, you know, any support for the kernel, so he's going backwards. So as you can see, it's still 2.3.3. Now, a couple quick things about this, like you say, as you can see, the menu looks pretty nice, pretty nifty. Wow, as you can see, it's colored down there now, so you have a nice colored menu. If you go into, oh, you want to see that, you know, like I say, it's about the same as before. As you can see, it does carousel. I mean, there is no lag between the screens, you can see. I mean, I have pretty much no lag before, you know, it was, the response was horrible. So let's go into the camera so you can see the camera app. They did, if I'm correct, enable panorama. How to do that, I don't know. But as you can see, the menu buttons are colored on this one, on this side. And basically, let's see what we got here. If you go into the menu for the camera, there's the self timer, the on, the image, custom. We have review duration, widescreen mode, geotagging, auto enhance, auto focus, face detection, shutter sound, grid, and reset to defaults. You can come on out of there, but pretty much all the options are the same. You're just colored now. So basically what they did is went more in depth with the theming. In case you missed the first video, let's go back to quick settings. Again, we have auto brightness, vibration mode, silent mode, auto rotation all added to the quick settings. And you see mobile network, and you can see it usually sits around 112 as far as the free space on here. You know, you can always kill all those and refresh it, and I'm sitting about, as you can see, 173 free, 173 megabytes, which is great. I mean, especially for it to be skinned as heavily as it is. You can see the rosy as the color patches down there. You can go in, there's five to a row. They have removed pretty much all the T-Mobile bloatware. The things that you see that they do include in here is ad-free to get rid of the ads and the pop-ups when you're visiting sites on the phone. The updated busy boxes, you can see one of the best things about it, they edit the cache app cleaner, as you can see. Bow. You can see that. It tells you the cache that's built up. One click, clear all cached files, and they're gone. So now you can clear your cache just that easy. Like you said, updated busy box. The Daemon controller is there. The Daemon controller, basically, I don't need to even mess with this. I don't mess with the stuff, but the wake state settings are there, and they did include that in the ROM. Let's see. Downloads, the dock mode. Folder editor is in there. And I believe there's a Core Droid file manager, which is one of their own file managers, which is better than, I can honestly say it's better than Astro or anything else you've ever seen. Like, honestly, this is way more extensive. I had Astro auto installed itself because I had it, you know, before I had this. Let's see what else we got. Java is in here. I've never noticed that before. Let's see what else we got that they included, because I know pretty much what comes in here. Let's see. Pretty much, I believe that's it, guys. Spare parts is in here. I've never messed with that too much. I can see the updated super user. You can see it right there. He has a pirate eye on him. That's really nice. And, like I said, I really want to get into this. Google Talk. Like I said, it is the new version of GTalk. So, as you can see, like I said, you see the camera is there. It is very functional. It works very well. And, I mean, this is phenomenal. I mean, they got it working and functional. Also, as you can see, we have, hold down the power button on top and press the home key if I bring it back. Screenshot saved to camera shots. So now, if I go to my gallery, which is by chance the same, camera shots, you see, there it is. Took a screenshot of my screen. Now, like I said, for you T-Mo USA users, no need to panic. It is there. So, go ahead if I turn, excuse me, I turn Bluetooth on. If I turn Wi-Fi off, you are going to see that 4G icon is right there. So, for you guys that panic about that, it is there. No need to panic. Everything's fine. Your standard animations are there. Everything works about the same as normal. So once you tap that, I think I've tapped like three things at once, so excuse me. As you can see, animations in there, I've turned off the sound, and pretty much they've themed that also, so it's blue, stuff like that. The dialer is also, as you can see, it's blue now. So I said shout out to Sergio the Crip. We see you gangbanging across the U.S. And you have HTC phone, which they've rethemed. Like I said, they've re-logoed and re-scanned a lot of these. The market right there is blue. They've included the new market. We're not going to go into quadrants again. As I say, quadrants are not a true way to tell because you can like fake your quadrant easy. You know, and I don't really like to get into this stuff. But pretty much you can see everything is pretty, you know, pretty, I mean, fast and smooth. I mean, everything I'm clicking, this is on 4G. So, let's get into something where you guys can see how fast an application opens up. Let's go to Twitter. Pretty instant. Let's see how fast it takes for it to load. Okay, it's spinning. It's already loaded up one. So, and I have a lot of followers, so. And bam, there you go. You guys can see that is crazy. So I mean, pretty much this is it. Cordroid 1.4. As you can see, like you said, they've completely revamped the power widget, and it's beautiful. I love it. Facebook does not come with it, but they did include the Twitter, the official Twitter app, and it is in there. So as you can see, it's right there. I don't use it much. But everything, like I say, functions. I mean, there's nothing much. I've downloaded a Volume Plus to go with it to boost my volume, but they did add a 20% volume increase that goes. Let's look at the speed on this. See what we can get from a quick speed test. Let's hit them up. This is daytime, peak time, like I said, it's 6 p.m. So, you know, I wouldn't expect much different, you know, in your area. It's kind of slow. So, as you can see, it's really slow during the day. Yeah, you know, if I catch this again about 10, 11 o'clock at night. So, you know, I mean, pretty slow. I mean, but I did hit last night. What did I hit last night? Let's see. Results. As you can see, before, those are when I was throttled, and this is as soon as I came off of throttle, and basically I'm not hitting too high speeds, even though I am technically in a HSPDA area. Let's see, you can go to settings. Well, actually let's go down to about phone, and let's take a look, see where I'm at. Where am I at? Networks. You can see I'm on UMTS right now, so that's not good. And pretty much, you guys have got the gist. Oh, they took out, like I say, TelHTC is gone. So, you know, if you guys have any information, you can visit cordroidroms.com. I'll put it on the screen. However, YouTube no longer allows us to put the links in the description bar. But Corduroy ROMs is the place to go to get all the new ROMs, or you can visit Sergio and the Doctor. You can visit those two on XDA Developers under the HTC Sensation forums. And you should be able to find those guys pretty easy under Corduroy ROMs. And I hope you guys enjoy 1.4 and moving forward. This is FreshDroid TV. You guys have a good one. Thank you, and goodbye, Las Vegas.